North Lakes Academy in Forest Lake is reinventing the way he teaches students about the world. He's developed a website that kind of works like fantasy football, except the students draft countries to play fantasy geopolitics.
R.K. Renner went to his classroom today to find out exactly how it works.
We're going to draft today.
Ask any boss or teacher. Nothing wastes time more than fantasy football.
It's so addicting.
We'll give you another minute.
Mr. Nelson even caught the fantasy bug in college while creating his social studies curriculum.
So I thought about having students draft countries and world leaders and develop global competence that way. Don't show it to anybody.
And he's found nothing breeds competence like fierce competition.
I'm really competitive, and I gotta win this.
Looking to compete with my fellow classmates, it makes it way more intense.
Your smack talk?
Yeah, oh yeah.
Now I'm like looking up articles on what's happening and like trying to figure out which countries I can switch with mine.
Today they're drafting countries for the Winter Olympics.
Top countries that might perform well in the Winter Olympics. Go.
Canada.
Canada.
First pick went to Germany.
Why would you not pick Canada?
No.
Each country is assigned a number of points based on how many times they're mentioned in the New York Times. Students can then continue to do their research at home and make trades at the website fantasygeopolitics.com.
The more a student figures out something about a country, the more they want to dive in and learn about it, because it helps them sort of do better, you know, on their team.
Eric Nelson has turned another distraction into an asset in his lessons. He lets his students use their smartphones.
They're always on their phones and they're always on their technology, but they're using it differently now.
I looked up the past rankings as far as medals went and drafted the ones that were still available.
It's a new way to make a distraction into an educational attraction. In Forest Lake, Kate Renner, 5 Eyewitness News.
What a great idea. Now, close to 30 classrooms across the country are testing out the Fantasy Geopolitics program online. Mr. Nelson says winning and losing in the Fantasy League, though, doesn't affect the students' grades. But they take it seriously, of course, for bragging rights. Nelson is trying to improve the website and make it more interactive for students. He started a Kickstarter campaign and has almost reached now his goal of $10,000. There are still 11 days to go, and so far, 111 backers have pledged more than $8,800. If you'd like to take a look, head to our website at kstp.com and click on links.